Deep Tea Galeron joins me on the set now to take a look at what the papers are saying today. Hi, Deep Tea.
Hi, Jeannie.
Lots of focus, of course, on the fifth anniversary of the attack on satirical magazine Charlie Hebdo that left 12 people dead.
That's right. We didn't know it at the time, but it was actually the first in a series of terror attacks on French soil that would go on to kill over 250 people, Jeannie. It also sparked a huge debate around Muslim integration and saw unprecedented strict security measures implemented into the daily lives of French people. Now, that magazine, Charlie Hebdo, has published a special edition today with a cartoon from Coco entitled New Censorship, New Dictatorships. The editor of the paper, Rhys, who was actually a survivor of the Charlie Hebdo attacks, deplores in the editorial today society's obsession with political correctness. He says, I quote, "Yesterday we stuck our finger up at God, at the army, at the church, at the government. Today, as much as terrorism is our enemy, so too are the social networks which police our society and, quote, wrap us on the knuckles like a school teacher."
Now, there was also a very strong message from the French newspaper Libération on this anniversary day.
Well, you'll remember all those I am Charlie slogans that erupted in the wave of this attack. Well, Libération on its front page today says, "We are all still Charlie." The daily paper, looking at what remains of the mobilization that rose out of those attacks, while paying tribute to Charlie Hebdo, which never renounced on holding the torch for freedom of expression despite incessant criticism. La Croix, the editorial paper, the Catholic paper, has a lovely tribute on its front page. You see the faces of some of those killed in the Charlie Hebdo attacks forming a flame lit by a pencil. And in fact, the paper also dedicates 7 cartoons to Charlie Hebdo today, also questioning what remains of the legacy of that post-freedom of expression movement. You'll see in one of the cartoons there, on the tombstone, it says, "Here lays political incorrectness."
Let's move on now to another big story we're covering today in Australia, where cooler temperatures and rain have finally brought precious but little respite to the bushfires.
Yeah, the raging bushfires have destroyed thousands of homes, killed dozens of people, and decimated the ecosystem in Australia. Along with the homes, Australia's treasured biodiversity has gone up in flames, as the French paper 20 Minutes says here. And we've been hearing this and figure really shared widely on social media, 500 million animals killed, half a billion. It's hard to fathom how we could exactly get to that number. And in fact, the American website Vox explains that the figure was conceived, the formula for the figure was conceived back in 2007 by a biodiversity expert, Chris Dickman, who co-authored a report for the World Wildlife Fund on the impact of land clearing on Australian wildlife. And he and his colleagues basically mined previous studies for estimates of mammal population density and then multiplied that by the areas of vegetation. And that's how he was able to come to this figure, which, to be honest, for the moment, could be more, could be less. We'll only know in the months to come. One guest writer for The Guardian calls this apocalyptic Australian summer Australia's Sandy Hook moment. After the 2012 shooting at a preschool in the U.S., many thought gun politics would change forever, but it didn't. And Australia faces the same decision now. If it doesn't take measures now, it will never be able to.
Next now, a casino in Romania that's over 100 years old is set to finally get an upgrade.
Yeah, this is, when you see the pictures of this casino, it's quite breathtaking. It juts out into the Black Sea in the city of Constanta. It's a magnificent but derelict casino, a vestige in the, quote, lost age of opulence, as the Times says rather eloquently. It opened in 1910 and quickly became the place to be seen for Europe's jet set royals and celebrities brushing shoulders across the poker tables, Jeannie. The casino is noted for its ornate ceilings, and it's got a clamshell sea-facing window, a building so beautiful that it was actually replicated in Monte Carlo. And then the war came, of course, and decades of communism that left the building abandoned, closed off to the public, and crumbling into the sea. Until now, with millions of dollars, they're going to hopefully restore the magnificent structure and use it perhaps as an arts and cultural space.
Just to wrap up now, Deepti, the film Cats recently came out in movie theaters, and to say the least, it hasn't been getting such a great reaction.
Yeah, that's right. The Andrew Lloyd Webber adaptation featuring Taylor Swift and a cast of creepy cat humans was ridiculed, mocked. It was deemed a commercial flop. Universal Studios going to lose a lot of money on that one, too. The Washington Post, disclaimer here, which, like France 24, does not condone drug use, has nonetheless interviewed hundreds of people who've gotten high while watching Cats, high out of their minds on illicit and legal drugs. And the verdict is we're not quite sure if being high makes cats better or worse. Some say they were terrified, actually, while watching Cats, especially the weird feline hybrids really freaked them out. Some had to wrestle with their own attraction to certain characters. Others were caught in fits of laughter. The Post says, who knows, maybe one day Cats might become a stoner classic for the ages.
Poor Cats. I still want to see it. My musical comedy side still wants to go see it.
I don't want to see it.
I'll keep you posted. Deepti, thank you so much for that. If you want to get a closer look at our press review today, don't forget, you can always check it out on our website, that address, france24.com.